published 1426 est the 8th of January 2018, updated 1917 est the 8th of January 2018. The video assistant referee of VAR was set up for the first time in an English competitive game at the Amex Stadium on Monday night for Brighton's 21 win over Crystal Palace in the third round of the FA Cup. VAR's debut was mostly quiet, until Glenn Murray's late winning goal for Brighton sparked debate over why WASNT used to see if the ball struck his arm or not. As replays were shown on the big screens at the Amex Stadium, the Crystal Palace away supporters demanded a review which never came. Andre Mariner was the man in the middle during VAR's debut at the Amex on Monday night. Glenn Murray's winner was the only real moment of contention during the FA Cup clash. Referee Andre Mariner was backed by assistant Neil Swarbrick, who was watching the game on television in the Premier League's West London studio, and former referee Graham Poole believes they made the right call on the late goal. Officials were able to use between 12 and 15 camera angles plus 4 cameras in each goal to try to ensure the right decision was made during Brighton's win over Palace, but opted not to use the technology for Murray's winner. VAR applies to 4 key areas: goals, red cards, penalties or cases of mistaken identity which disrupt the flow of the game. The on-field referee can also request a pitch-side review of an incident or decision from the VAR if he himself is unsure about a decision. This could have happened in the Nottingham Forest v Arsenal game, where John Moss and his assistants appeared unsure if Kieran Dowell had touched the ball twice as he slipped over, taking a penalty. The VAR watched the game away from the stadium. With a bank of TV feeds from the match, there was no feed available of the video review either for TV viewers or those in the ground. There was no feed available of the video review either for watchers on TV or for those inside the stadium. It is kept for the referees only. Fans will therefore only know if the video is in use by observing the referee's signal drawing a rectangle in the air with his fingers, as well as a VAR review sign appearing on stadium screens, and the delays to play. Also controversial is the fact a review can take around 2 minutes. Clear errors are usually quite obvious and the time is often shorter, but there have been major problems in Italy and Germany, where some are unconvinced by the technology. Juventus coach Massimiliano Allegri complained that the game was turning into baseball on average. A VAR call is made every 3 games where it is available. Former referee Mike Riley inspects the video assistant referee system in London. Video assistant referee VAR was available for the first time in an English competitive game. An off-field official can inform the referee about incidents relating to goals and red cards. After all the build-up, the video referee had a fairly quiet introduction to the English game on Monday night. The only real incident of note, aside from the routine check after the first 2 goals, was Murray's late winning goal, which some suggested struck his arm. However, I don't think the ball hit Murray's arm and it's not a clear and obvious error, so they would NT need to intervene on that. The ball did not appear to strike Murray's arm, however, and it looked to be the right decision. The goal stood and Brighton sealed the 21 win over Palace to book their place in the next round, so the match actually accurately reflected what the video referee is about. It is only used if absolutely necessary and if a decision is obviously incorrect. The video referee will not intervene in grey areas. In football, we must always try and maintain the referee's integrity, so it won't just be used freely for the sake of it. There will be lots of games, like this one, where it isn't required, particularly as we are fortunate to have a high standard of officiating in this country. Rio Ferdinand, speaking on BT Sport's coverage of the match, said the images were inconclusive on whether it was handball or not by Murray. You'll have all the fans from Crystal Palace saying why wasn't the other angle looked at, Ferdinand said. We've got the Palace fans in the away end here who were asking us whether it was handball or not, and the pictures we saw were kind of inconclusive in some respects. I thought initially it was definitely from off his knee, but if we had another angle maybe you'd be able to see the other side if it's off his arm as well. The debate is still there. Brighton players celebrate after Murray's goal secured a 21 victory over Derby rivals Palace. You've got human error. We've got the visuals and the different pictures after and it's still inconclusive. His co-pundit Steven Gerrard said he couldn't tell if the ball brushed Murray's arm or not and insisted it was crucial that VAR had every angle available to make the right calls on the big decisions. I think it definitely clipped his knee first, he told BT Sport. Whether it brushed his arm or not, but I don't think there was any intention there from me. The goal should have stood and they've got it right. Mariner fielded questions from Crystal Palace players after Murray's late winning goal, but it is important that VAR have every single angle possible to make these big decisions. People are going to say you haven't seen it from that angle, and then it keeps the debate going and the argument. There's no point having it, Ferdinand added. It has to be cleared up completely and there can't be left no grey areas. If you've got the actual replays there, that should just be that's it. Everyone should get all of the different pictures for them to make a decision as once and final that everyone can agree on. But when you don't get certain pictures and people at home are saying, why are the people, the powers that be, getting the right pictures?